It's pretty godlike series.
All right, but here we go. Starting off the first match, it looks like they're going to. I'm going to take a guess and say Smashville.
Yes, it is going to be Smashville. And we've got another Diddy Kong versus Sheik matchup.
These
no
are actually
surprises here.
Very interesting to watch nowadays, considering the patches. It's not, you know, so bread and butter as you would expect it to be, where it's just down throw up airs from both characters. It's unique.
Right. Yeah, there's definitely a lot of diversity in the follow-up game and the kill setup game in this matchup. It used to literally be, as you said, you know, up throw up airs or down throw up air into 50-50. But both characters really have to play a lot more honest and solid than they did before.
And this is a matchup that Vinny has practiced quite a lot, because if people play the most at the house, we're Vinny and K9. So let's see what Retina can do about this.
That's not surprising to me at all. Those guys are fiends.
They're super fiends. Fiend of Cali versus the Fiend of New York.
Yeah. They're very frequently found with controllers in their hands.
Okay. Not fair.
So Vinny's opponent, Retina, not a Diddy Kong player I'm familiar with.
Vinny's really good at getting grabs. I don't know if you noticed that. He'll double jab. Even if you sidestep it, he'll grab you right afterwards because there's not much lag on that attack.
Right. Sheik's double jab is actually unsafe on block, though. So the correct answer to that is to just hold shield. As soon as you see that double jab, scoop her up. But Vinny catching a classic Sheik bouncing fish through the air dodge off the side of the stage. Gonna see a lot of that this tournament.
Oh, for sure. Especially these types of Sheiks, the high-level Sheiks, they will always do the needles. They'll charge it at some point in time and use that specifically for when they need to get the KO.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, he did do needles to bounce.
Yeah,
fish.
Needles to bounce fish.
My bad, my bad.
So he's charging it up right now. If he had hit him out of the barrels, that might have been a KO. All
right, and another conversion into the bouncing fish. That does 12 fresh, so, you know, Sheik's forward air only does 4 damage when it's fresh. So 12 is actually kind of a big hit for her. And
oh, goodness.
Wow, speaking of big hits, man.
That was a very good follow-up. Doing a down throw and knowing that the platform is there. If they air dodge and you do that up B, they're dead. If they land on the platform without a tech, they're dead. Even if they tech, they might be dead. So
yeah.
That was a very good choice of a follow-up by Vinny.
Yeah, and that wasn't even just pure reaction or anything. It was like, okay, this is going to cover a lot of options.
Mm-hmm.
And Retina happened to pick one that it would have covered.
Yeah, I think that was the best choice.
Interesting. Not the counterpick I would ever expect. Like, oh, he plays Diddy Kong, he got bodied by the Sheik. All right, if he's going to switch characters, let's see, maybe a Mario, maybe a Sheik Ditto. No.
Is going, he going to go Cloud?
Going, yeah, right?
I'm going my pocket Wii
straight fit. Down the tier list.
My pocket Wii Fit. All right, well, let's see what Redna can do with this character. I feel like this is a bad matchup for Wii Fit, too. But,
it really is. She gets danced on by Sheik's framed anime.
Yeah.
She has nothing out of shield that can respond to forward air so well.
But John Numbers did defeat Vinny that one time. I know Vinny's beaten him like 50 plus times.
Yeah, dude. I think that's kind of grasping at straws.
Yeah. So probably won't mean much of a difference. But it does mean that he might be able to lose to Wii Fit.
Also, Rin beat False twice.
Oh.
But that was a completely different style of Wii Fit from what we're seeing from Retina right now. Yeah, it was a lot more like that.
Yep.
But Vinny definitely keen to it, and he didn't even try the up B.
Oh, yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
You should have at least given a shot. I feel like Wii Fit can recover from the depths, so definitely a shame.
You can't grab the edge against Sheik, or twice, against Sheik like this caliber. They will down air spike you, and it's completely safe. They just do it and they don't like risk anything.
Yeah, when you're playing a Sheik that doesn't look for that, it's actually relatively safe to grab the edge a second time against her because she doesn't have much that can hit the edge. But if you're playing someone like Vinny, Void, Mr. R, False, they know. They're looking for that.
Yeah. And this is going to be tough recovery. As it fully charged needles, he's going to go for the needles to bounce the fish. And there's the KO.
Oh no, there's not
he
the
lived.
KO.
Okay, is he going to upbeat this time?
Yeah, yeah. At least try it, man.
All
this guy's name is Retina. He should be able to see when he can get back. He can see everything. Can he see the path to victory against Vinny is the question.
And that might be the up air. Oh, good choice by not air dodging. At this percent, it's best to just jump away from Sheik when he hits you in there.
I think he's just trying to make this match take as long as possible. He's like, all right, I want as much gameplay in this set to warm up for my next one, so I'm just going to run away from here.
Oh my goodness, almost got that bouncing fish read. And once again, good choice by jumping wave.
Well, he's definitely staying alive. Oh, wow, Vinny just going to intercept that stand-up from the edge with down smash. So many hits on that move that it has a good chance of catching you, even though standing up from the edge is relatively safe.
Very true, and I believe even if he rolled at that time, he would have still got hit by the down smash because the down smash covers so much range.
Right.
So doing it very close to the edge was a good choice by Vinny. And congrats to him on his nice clean 2-0. And it looks like we're going to see Zenyu,
perhaps?
No.
Oh, no, just faking us out, walking right past. Okay. Oh, Trevante, though.
Trevante jumping on from NorCal, I believe. I believe he's a Fox main. He was a Fox main previously. So, but with
he
all these patches?
No, I think he means Sheik. in this
game.
Oh,
yes, you're right.
He was a Fox
main
in Brawl, though.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, in Smash 3, he played Fox.
But what if he has a Fox now?
He could. I mean, he should, honestly. Especially if you played the character before. He's still very similar to how he was in Brawl, except, honestly, just flat-out better now.
Yeah, that's true. And Fox, a lot of people were doubting Fox in the beginning of the metagame, but as other characters got patched and Fox just increased. Yeah, it pretty much didn't. That's a good one right there. And Larry showed what Fox can do, all the conversions into up smash, downer up smash, neutral up smash. A lot of people have been picking up Fox, so we'll see who he'll play, but most likely it'll be Sheik.
He also used to have a Palutena back in the days of customs. We could have seen that last year, but I don't think we'll see her this year. Even though Palutena's kind of on the rise, man, with Prince Ramen, Ice Ninja, a lot of players doing some work with her. CEO is like Palutena's weekend.
Yeah, for sure.
I actually started playing her because of that. I saw Zero lose. I'm like, all right, it's over. We're playing
Palutena.
This character. Yeah, she's really fun.
Yeah, she looks like she's fun, especially with those combos she has. She's very quick, too. You think there's a lot of lag after attacks,
sure.
And she just, boom, grabs you out of nowhere.
Yeah, she moves fast, and her attacks are fast. Like, only certain ones. Only, like, her fair and jab, which is still slow. It's an 8-frame jab, but it ends quickly.
Yeah.
But yeah, Palutena definitely an interesting character. I'd love to see Trevante bust her out, but I don't think